Hello, good morning, happy day to all. In this class, I am going to discuss about break-even analysis. Now the question arises, what is break-even analysis? What? Why it should be calculated? And how it should be calculated? What, why and how? For these three questions, I am going to explain in this video. Break-even analysis is one of the tool which is used in marginal costing technique. Actually, marginal costing technique is the one of the management accounting tool. It means it gives some sort of suggestions to management to decide on certain important business decisions. Regarding break-even analysis, it is the analysis used to determine how much sales volume is required. Sales volume is required means what? It means the sales point at which the company or the business starts to earn profit. It means to determine how much sales volume is required to start making profit. So it is highly useful for marketing plan or business plan. In economics and business, specifically in cost accounting, the break-even point is the point at which total cost is equal to total revenue. We can say total cost is equal to total revenue. Or otherwise, there is no net loss or gain. There is no net loss or gain and one has broken even. That's why it is termed as break-even. So break-even means the point where the total cost is equal to total revenue, or otherwise it can be termed as there is no net loss or gain and one has broken even. Now let me see further things on break-even analysis. So before going to know about what is break-even analysis and how it is calculated, it is very important to know the key terms which we are going to use in the computation. The very first one I have given is fixed cost. Fixed cost is the cost which is incurred irrespective of the sales volume. Whether there is sales or whether there is production in the company or not, the fixed cost will be incurred. For example, salary, rent of the building, like that. Certain expenses are to be paid irrespective of the earnings of the company or irrespective of the production of the company. These expenses are termed to be fixed cost. Variable cost, as per the name, it varies according to the production. It varies according to the sales. When there is increase or decrease in sales or production, variable cost also will increase or decrease. The third term I have given is sales value. It is nothing but the sales in rupees. Sales amount in rupees. Sales volume refers to the sales units. And next word I have given is selling price per unit. What is the selling price per unit? And contribution. Contribution is nothing but the difference between selling price and variable cost. That means selling price per unit minus variable cost. That is called contribution per unit. Next, let me explain how. That is how the break-even analysis is computed. So there are two approaches. One is based on volume, that is sales volume. And another one is based on rupees, sales rupees. A formula, I have given two formulae. The first one is break-even point in sales volume. The formula I have given is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. So fixed cost is the cost which is available, which is the data will be available in the question itself. Total fixed cost incurred. Regarding contribution per unit, we will be given the details about selling price and variable cost. So selling price minus variable cost, we will get contribution per unit. So applying this formula, we will be able to compute the sales volume in units. It means only after those sales units, after having crossed the VEP sales volume, the company starts making profit. And next formula given is BEP in sales value, that is in rupees, in terms of rupees. The previous formula have been extended. The previous formula is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. The answer is multiplied with selling price per unit, which yield the sales value in rupees. So this is regarding break-even point in sales in rupees. Next, let me explain with an example. I have given the example for break-even in unit and as well as break-even in sales value. The first example I have given is fixed cost 20,000 rupees. Contribution. So here, as per the data, the contribution per unit is 10 rupees. So applying the formula break-even in units, fixed cost by contribution per unit, we get 2,000 units. So it means up to 2,000 units, the company has no profit. If their sales is 1,500 units, there is no profit. If the sales is 1,800 units, there is no profit. If the sales becomes 2,000, there is no profit, no loss. Less than 2,000 units means there is loss. When they cross 2,000, from 2001 onwards, they have profit. So only for that purpose, break even in unit is calculated. The second formula I have given, break even in sales value. So here I have applied fixed cost by contribution per unit into selling price per unit. The arrived answer is multiplied with selling price per unit. So we have the answer 2000 units. The 2000 units is multiplied with 20 rupees per unit, which is the selling price, which amounts to 40,000 rupees. So it means if the company is having a sales of 40,000 rupees, there is no profit or loss. After having crossed 40,000, every 1 rupee is their profit. So they have to fix their sales target as in rupees means 40,000. In units means 2,000 units. Next table will give the illustration. That is, I would like to illustrate the chart. BEP chart I have prepared. Here I have given the sales units 500, 1000, 1500 and so on up to 2100. Take case of the first one, 500 units. Selling price per unit I have given is 20 rupees. So total sales comes to 10,000 rupees. According to the data, the total cost, variable cost and fixed cost amounts to 25,000. There is a loss of 15,000 rupees. Come to the second one, 1000 units. Regarding the, whenever there is 1000 units, the total sales comes to 20,000 rupees. Again, there is a loss of 10,000. Like that, it goes on. When sales unit becomes 2000 units, look at the table, there is no profit, no loss. If it is 2001 unit, there is a profit of 10 rupees. If the sales unit is 2100, there is a profit of 1000 rupees. It goes on an increasing trend. So that is why we need to compute break-even analysis. So like this, any business, they have to prepare charts for various level of sales units to find out their break-even point. So after having computed the break-even point, the company will fix the target, sales target for the particular month or for the particular year. So their sales should not be less than the BEP units. The sales should be above the BEP units. For this purpose only BEP is calculated. I hope in this module you are able to understand how the BEP is calculated and how it is interpreted. If there is any clarification in further discussions, we can clarify. Thank you.